it's not really as simple as we thought. Because, Anthony, there are other combinations that at the moment we're still looking into. Tell us, beside atezo-bev, what else is going on?
So sticking with the concept of combining immuno-oncology agents like anti-PD-1 or PD-L1 agents with generally what we call anti-VEGF agents. Now, we talked about bevacizumab, which is an anti-VEGF antibody. However, the TKIs all have VEGF inhibition among other targets. So we have a combination of pembrolizumab, lenvatinib. We've seen phase 1b data with that combination. That looks promising. Again, with the response rates with these combinations are all sitting around the 30% range, roughly, and a median PFS of above 7 months or so. Now there's a phase 3 ongoing, the LEAP trial, comparing pembrolizumab, lenvatinib to lenvatinib. We're awaiting the completion of that trial. There are multiple similar combinations. There's cabozantinib with atezolizumab being evaluated in a phase 3 study as well. Cosmic trial, thank you. There are several phase 1b studies that are being reported. So lenvatinib plus nivolumab from Japan, pembrolizumab with regorafenib as well. So all around the same theme, and again, all showing this response rate in the 30% range. What's important to wait for are the readouts related to survival and the readouts related to toxicity. There's no question that based on the early data we are seeing, that combining an anti-PD-1 or PD-L1 antibody with a TKI can result in some toxicity requiring dose interruptions, dose reductions, and probably a slightly higher rate of grade 3 and 4 toxicities compared to single agent. So that's something to keep in mind. The last comment I'll make is that the other category of, or the other combination that's being evaluated in first line is IO-IO combinations, specifically PD-1 or PD-L1 with CTLA-4. So we've seen phase 1b, phase 2 data from Checkmate 040 with nivolumab plus ipilimumab. And we know that there's early phase data from durvalumab, tremelimumab, which is now being evaluated in a phase 3 trial known as Himalaya. This is ongoing, and the nivolumab-ipilimumab combination is being evaluated in another Checkmate trial. I forget the number of it.
Sure.
To comment briefly on the IO-IO combinations, what we've seen from the nivolumab-ipilimumab combination, there were three different schedules and doses being evaluated, so it makes it a bit complicated. The response rate, again, is about 31% with that. There was higher toxicity with the higher ipilimumab dose, 3 milligram per kilogram. But when looking at survival, the higher ipi dose resulted in a median OS of 22 months or so, compared to 12 to 13 months with the lower ipi doses. The study was not powered to compare survival across these different schedules and doses, so more follow-up is needed there. And with Durva-Trami, we saw some early data with response rates around 17%. But again, we await the phase 3 data for that.
So Ahmed, of those different combinations that we're talking about, and understandably, we don't have the data. I totally agree with Anthony. We don't have the data yet, but except for a few of them. Of them kind of is more appealing from your perspective? You think it's like more interesting scientifically or in regard to what are the potential adverse events?
Yeah, so the major advantage that, you know, we're watching now and the field is evolving so fast is the fact that we've gone beyond this glass ceiling of monotherapy, of immunotherapy, giving us 15% response rate, 4 months of TTP. Now we're at a different level where we went up to about 30%, still not a home run yet, so we still have ways to go. But it's really providing our patients with an advantage of prolonged survival with drugs that they can tolerate. So we're still encountering this major issue of being just in the palliative space. So I think back to our point earlier about moving systemic to earlier stages, very, very critical at this point, even not only in child in Barcelona Clinic B, maybe A, patients who are undergoing surgery. So we're going to see a wave. Our team and others are doing new adjuvant. So these strategies are really going to transform the role of immunotherapy and targeted therapy from palliative to potentially being curative in future.